Welcome back everyone, my name is Heinrich, this is my channel From Learning where I talk about what it takes to be successful in the first years of your career. And today you find me at a bit of an unusual place. I'm currently in our flat in Italy, in Milan. For those of you who don't know, I'm half Italian, so parts of my family still lives in Italy, here in Milan to be precise, which is why here I'm enjoying now a weekend with members of the family, visiting the city, visiting the university where I spent a semester abroad during my undergraduate years here, the Bocconi Business School in Milan. Great memories, for sure a great experience. But today what this video is going to be all about is talking about the challenges, the questions that you might have as a young professional. So as someone who is in the first years of his or her career, I know that this can be difficult. I experienced this myself when I was in my first years as a fellow business analyst and associate working for the consulting firm McKinsey. Surely this is not always easy. So I asked you on Instagram what the biggest challenges and questions are that you faced during that time. So let's get into that. I will do my best to give you some perspectives on these. Now, based on the survey I did on Instagram, I got several questions and challenges from people like you saying that their colleagues or clients telling you that you are too young. So how to get over that? What is my experience? And yes, I can relate to that because I did have several instances while working in consulting and also later in the job where there were people on the team that were not really that well accepted by clients that got comments, especially in the beginning, especially due to their age. And often it's not even due to their actual age, but often just also due to the perceived age. Of course, it doesn't help to look very young. Here, my experience is though that over the course of working together, over the course of such a relationship, you can overcome this just by being helpful and really adding value to the client. And indeed, what you can do as a junior person is often not so much winning with industry domain expertise. Of course, you will often not be the biggest expert of what is going in an industry. You will not have already seen it all. But what often the skill is that you can bring to the table, especially in a consulting context, especially if you're already analytically minded, is really the power of data. So it's really difficult to argue with you, even if you're very young and you look very inexperienced. If you're sitting in a meeting and you conducted a well-researched, well-carried-out analysis, and now you're confronting people with facts, with numbers, with data, if you do this well, if you present this well, I mean, it's very difficult then to argue with you. And if you show that you can do that, if you show that you really have some insights, that you can contribute by doing this, you will get taken seriously. The next one is to ask the right questions. So maybe exactly because you're not that experienced yet, sometimes you may struggle to really come up with good and helpful questions. You wonder maybe how can you contribute in meetings. And here one sneaky little tip that I picked up over time is that, especially if you have an important meeting, you are maybe a junior having a document that is being presented, think about this in advance. Go over the document and look at some like good pages and think about what things would be that you would be able to ask in a meeting that would be really insightful, that really maybe also would make you look good, make you look smart. And then at the right times, if the situation allows it, ask for these things. And independent of how you see it, certainly if you prepare a bit, have a bit more time in advance, it will be much easier for you really to add value, ask the right things, ask meaningful questions, than if you just sit in the meeting not really prepared and need to come up with things like that on the spot. The next one is to how to interact with managers, colleagues and clients at the beginning of a new job, because they don't know you, you don't know them, so how you interact with them. Surely here's now lots of things that can be said on all different types of nuances to that. One tip that I want to share that I think makes a lot of sense and really can make a difference is that especially in the first weeks on a new project in consulting or in the first months if you work in industry, really try to give 200%, give 300%, go above and beyond. Because my experience is if you've established this reputation in the beginning, that you are really this superstar, that you are this rock star consultant, that you are this like top 1% employee. If this is the reputation that you established in the beginning, This will go a very long way. Maybe you're not able to continue like this forever, and of course that's okay. But I would absolutely be cautious of is really to start rather on the opposite, to start a bit slower, maybe a bit insecure, not doing that much. This often is difficult because then you have the opposite effect. Then to recover from that and turn this reputation around is really then a long way that you need to go. Next thing is about dealing with imposter syndrome. So what do you do if you feel like you really have imposter syndrome, that you don't really deserve to be here, that it feels like all these other people are so much smarter than you are? And I for sure remember this. I very well remember the first weeks on my very first project in consulting. I felt like I should not be here. I felt like I was working together on a team with other associates, other consultants, and these people seemed so above and beyond, so much smarter, so much more capable of me. I really remember after the first weeks wondering, asking myself whether I am the right person to do this job, whether I would at any point be able to be only half as good as these people. But the truth is, the learning curve is quite steep, and what you will only see is that where these people are, maybe 1 year tenure, 2 years tenure, this is such a development step from where you are as someone who just started out compared to someone who's already doing all of this after 1 or 2 years. Because what you don't realize in the beginning is that there are lots of little tips and tricks that might make you to be perceived as very confident, very knowledgeable, even if maybe in this specific moment you are not necessarily that confident and that well knowledgeable, right? And actually, I even did a video about this topic a couple of weeks or months ago. I will link it somewhere above here where I share some of these sneaky little tips and tricks what consultants and of course also many other people outside of consulting sometimes do to really create this very positive perception about themselves, which maybe is not really always backed up with hard knowledge, right? And of course, that's just part of the game as well. You will see this in all different types of professional services contexts and for sure also in industry. But learning these little things and then of course over time also getting the actual hard industry knowledge by all of this, it's very likely that in 1 or 2 years, you will suddenly be this quite experienced consultant associate who now works together with a new joiner. And trust me, this new joiner very likely will look up to you and think the very same things that you thought in the beginning. So I guess just trust the process. Of course, learn, be open-minded, learn the game, learn the skills, and you will be fine. The next one is about setting boundaries. How can you, even if you work in a high-paced environment with, of course, long hours, lots of pressure, how do you succeed to set boundaries, to also still carve out some time for yourself? And of course, this is often especially challenging in professional services like consulting, probably even more in banking, where just so much is expected from you. But here also my experiences, the people often that struggled most were really the new joiners, the junior people who were only in the firm for a couple of months. And then often these people feel like they need to do everything they're asked to do. They always need to say yes, whatever it takes. But then it was often the bit more experienced associates, 1 year, second year, third year associate, who knew the game a little bit better and that did manage quite well also to fence off some time, set these boundaries, and thereby also manage their work-life balance. And indeed, how to achieve this, my tip is that it's very fair to, for instance, in the beginning, have a conversation with your project lead or with your team lead in industry, wherever you work, where you very clearly state what is important to you, also regarding lifestyle. And of course, it's important to be realistic. So likely if you work for an MBB consulting firm like McKinsey, BCG or Bain, if you tell this project lead that you just expect that every evening you are done with work at 8 p.m., I mean, this is just completely not realistic, right? So this will not work. But what will work is that maybe you tell this project lead that it's important to you that at least one evening during the week, then at least a bit earlier at 8 or 9 p.m. or so, you have this evening to yourself, have the flexibility, for instance, to go to the hotel, hit the hotel gym. And then if there's more work to do, then maybe afterwards you can do that, right? Just as an example. Or maybe you state that it's very important to you that every lunchtime you get a warm meal, because maybe this is really what matters to you. You feel like if you don't have proper lunch every day, then you struggle to really do your job well. I mean, clearly state expectations like this, and if you clearly communicate this and then also act on that, Then my experience is everyone will understand, everyone will be okay, if the maybe even a bit earlier than the rest, maybe the rest of the team is then still working from the team room. But then you leave a bit earlier on that specific day to hit the gym because you clearly said that this is important to you. Another thing that several of you asked is my opinion on the point of specialization versus generalization. So at the beginning of your career, should you rather choose a path that leads you towards a general experiencing lots of different things, or more specialized one where you build deep domain knowledge in a specific area? And here certainly both paths can lead to great success, and I trust you can build a great career based on both of the types of things. In my humble opinion, I do think that there's a lot of value in the beginning of your career, really follow the generalist approach. See lots of different things. This is of course what you will be able to do in many consulting roles where you start in a generalist track and then in the first 1, 2, 3 years have the opportunity to see lots of different industries, lots of different functions. I think this has two main benefits. First, of course, by exposing yourself to many of these different areas, probably this will help you to make a more informed decision in which area, maybe at a later stage in your career, you really want to focus on. But then second, and this is really where I'm also drawing from right now, you know, having worked after consulting in a retail role, right now in a startup role, in a prop tech company, after working in all these different functions and industries, getting this broad experience, what this helps you build is confidence. Confidence that you are able to navigate lots of different environments, that you are able to add value in many, many different areas and instances of work. And this confidence, I think, is very easy to undervalue, to underestimate. I think it's quite an asset that you have the mindset that yes, more or less independent of what the setting is that you will enter in your professional life, also after professional services, if you enter industry at some point, doesn't matter what area exactly you work in, you learn some tools to make you successful in this area. You have the confidence that yes, you can add value. I would not underestimate that, what the value of this is. I do think, at least for me personally, it made quite a difference. And if you have the opportunity to collect this more generalist experience, I do think it is worthwhile to follow that, because then always after some time, there's still lots of opportunities to specialize. But to the contrary, if you already specialize in a quite significant way in the first years of your career, I would argue it's then quite difficult to then move towards a more general manager type of path, to move towards a path where then you do see different things. So do this in the beginning. I think this is, in my humble opinion, the sweet spot. I also got several questions on communication, so how to communicate effectively, how to structure your messages the right way, and so on and so forth. Of course, here are also many things to be said. I created several videos on communication-related topics in the past. I will link above here a playlist where you find them. And now a shameless plug, it's also no secret that I have this course on professional communications and slide writing. So if you're really serious to improve your communications game, I will leave a link to this course below in the video description where I talk a lot about professional slide writing communication skills. So check this out if this is of interest to you. So I hope this was helpful. Of course, let me also know in the comments whether you enjoyed this format, whether you'd like to see more videos like that. If you liked it, please hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm, subscribe to this channel to see more content like this. And of course, as always, a big thanks to all the members of Firm Learning. Thanks for your support. If you want to continue your learning journey, I will link additional videos here that I believe will be valuable to you. So until then, see you next week. This is Heini from Firm Learning, and bye-bye.